Jen, Steven Spader sat in court today with his head shaved, similar to what it looked like a year ago when he was arrested. Also today in court, he chose to read. He took a copy of the New Hampshire State Constitution.
Challenging task of narrowing a group of 400 potential jurors to a mere 16 to decide Steven Spader's fate continued on Thursday. 150 Hillsborough County residents packed into a room in Superior Court in Nashua, the second of three large panels. In keeping with Wednesday, Judge Jillian Abramson had accused murderer Steven Spader stand and face the group as part of required introductions. Spader had a different appearance, shaving his head, shedding the hair seen in this video from Wednesday. During the judge's one-hour instruction, jurors were told if chosen, they cannot be influenced by fear, bias, or sympathy. They cannot discuss the case with anyone, including their husbands or wives, and would have to avoid all forms of news. Jurors were then asked a series of questions, including whether hearing that an 11-year-old girl was badly injured in the case would affect their judgment, or whether viewing graphic photographs would impact their ability to serve on the jury. Prospective jurors were also asked if they knew any of the 70 people on the witness list, which includes the victim, Kimberly Kate's husband, David, and daughter, Jamie. Roughly 35 of the 150 said they had no conflict, almost the same number as the first group. Those who did have a conflict met one-on-one with Judge Abramson. Some were dismissed. Others were scheduled to return next week for questioning by both prosecutors and Spader's defense attorneys.
And the third and final jury panel will be screened tomorrow. We're told nearly all of next week is booked with one-on-one interviews with those jurors. And if all goes as planned, the trial should begin on October 25th. Live in the newsroom, Kriya Sakakini, WMUR News 9.